Hey, Radu here. So, what is a calculated field in a pivot table? What about calculated items? What's the difference between them? Let's find out. Radu, why do I even need calculated fields or items in a pivot table? Let's take an example. I have a pivot table right here that shows me a summary of some sales data, and I assume that those numbers are in dollars, and I want to convert them to from dollars to something else, something like lei. And yes, in theory, I could do something very simple like that. Just click on that and multiply it by 4.3 and it's over. But it doesn't really work, because if I multiply this formula, I'm gonna have a surprise. Okay, I'll see the same number over and over again. Why? Because of this formula, get pivot data. When I click on before, it shows me this. Okay, so if I want to calculate outside the pivot, I'm gonna write equals B4 and then multiply it by 4.3. This will work, but we have a disadvantage, because if I'm like adding something else here in the columns, it will overwrite my formula, and that's not very fun. Okay, so the first and most the easiest way is like has some disadvantages. The second way of doing this would be for me to go into the data table and calculate the sales into RON at the row level. Okay, that's not something that I want to do, because it makes me add more and more columns to the table and not very fun. Okay, so this is why we have pivot tables in Excel, to do something similar like to this, okay, but without calculating outside the pivot, and also without inserting new columns into our table. Let's see how they work. The hardest thing for us is to find the button here with the calculated fields. We can find it in the Analyze tab. Of course, you have to select the pivot. Analyze tab. Go and find fields, items, and sets. So that's where we want to go. And we want to go into calculated field. And it's very complicated, very complicated. I'm going to have to give it a name, something like sales RON. RON is the currency from Romania. I'm from Romania and I know how to translate it from dollars. The formula is very simple. I'm not writing here something like A1, B4, something like that, but actually I'm writing something like sales column multiplied by 4.3. Okay. So this is how you write the column. It's calculated on a column level and not at the cell level. If I click OK, it pretty much works. And the good thing is that when I'm doing things like that, I don't have to insert new columns into the table, and also I don't have to do calculations outside the pivot. Before we move on to calculated items, just want to point out one thing. So if we go back to our formula, and by the way, it's pretty hard to go and find the formula that you just written. You have to go into field items and sets, and you have to know, you have to select from this drop down and go into that one. Just saying. And if you see here, it says sales multiplied by 4.3, but that sales means sum of sales. So if you want to calculate something like average of sales multiplied by maximum of something else, it doesn't really work. It works only with the sum. If you want to be able to work with average, with max, minimum, so on, you'll probably want to use Power Pivot or maybe Power BI. Just want to point that out. Now, let's go into the calculated items territory. So let me just briefly modify this this pivot. I'm gonna take that out and I'm gonna put something else here, something like ship mode into columns. And as you can see, I have multiple ship modes into my example. And what I want to do is to group the first class and second class category. Why? I have no idea. I don't really know what that means, first class and second class, but I want to group them together because it make the report look better. So to do this, I'm going to use a calculated item. And the funny thing is the following. If I click here in the values territory, I'm gonna see that the calculated item is not available. But if I click over here in the table header, something like that, I can see that the calculated item is available. Why? I have no idea. So get into that. And I want to create a new column, something like first and second, and define a formula here. And as you can see, because I selected the cell here, it automatically selected the ship mode, and I can see, okay, this like first class plus second class. And if I click OK, I'm gonna see a new column here, first and second. And if I look closely, I'll probably realize that if I add these two, it's gonna equal that one. Okay, so I think calculated items are very suitable when you want to summarize a few information, a few columns in your report. Because in this case, I can have something like first and second, and maybe same day and whatever standard in a different column. And of course, a very important difference between those are the following. The calculated field appears here. I can see it here in the fields section. It's something like, it's somehow like a virtual column. The calculated item does not show here. It's only presented on the screen, and I can choose to filter it if I want to maybe show only that one, something like this. Before you go, I just want to make a short recommendation. If calculations in a pivot are really important for you, I would really recommend you to research a little bit about Power Pivot, because the calculations you can do in a Power Pivot are much better than what you can do in a pivot table. And also, if data analysis is very important for you, really recommend check out Power BI, because Power BI really has all the tools you need for very cool calculations and reports and so on. That was it. Hope it was useful for you. If yes, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more videos like this. See you in the next video.